This time on DawgStrip, we start a new project, turning two minivans into one. We chop, cut, torch, trim, and saw these vans down until we are finished with our newest ride for the upcoming BC Gambler 500.
This time we set our sights on the cheapest Astro vans we could. This one had a rotten subframe and no rear brakes, while the second was dead on arrival.
We waste little time diving into this project. After all, we've only got about 2 weeks of build time. All we need from this first van is a hollowed out front shell, so enjoy the montage as everything else not needed goes away.
This drive line was sold off to a new home while we kept a suspension and subframe for later repairs on the other van. Now it's time to break it to plasma cutter and let the sparks fly.
I think we had a tiny bit of rust there.
It doesn't always pay off to buy the cheapest vehicle you can.
All right, let's quit messing about. Cut this van in half. Bonkers.
With one down, there's one to go. Time to do it all over again, yet a little different.
You wanted burnouts, so you get burnouts. Sorry, neighbors. Get a little bad.
Now it's time to start the precise measurements while lining up the two van bodies. Measure once, cut three times.
As a DawgStrip pro tip, when using a plasma cutter, try to avoid fuel filters. Just saying.
Next, we earn our Egyptian merit badge by using only two human power to bring these two vans together. If anyone has an objection to this union, speak now or forever hold your peace.
Be strong, man. Push.
I don't have any strength left in me.
So one reason why we got this van so cheap was the subframe is rotten, and it only seems to be one horn of the frame. So we have another one. We're going to cut it off, weld it on. Highly don't recommend this, but always be gambling.
There is a new frame rail, just in case anybody ever wants to look at it. No one knows the difference.
For quick reference, this was the removed frame rail. Does not want.
One thing to overcome is the gap of where the sliding door used to be. Right here, we basically filled this in with a couple tabs, so now it's at least structural. And now we get to fill that giant hole with instant Bondo. Expanding foam. We're not proud of this, but time is short. Let's give it a try.
The expanding foam, aka the body filler, turned out pretty good. The rocker panels were in a rather poor state and ended up receiving the same treatment.
Whoa, this stinks.
We'll sand them down and give them a coat of paint, but we'll do that later. First, time to get this thing on the road and have a little fun.
I can't turn my wheel.
You're panicking.
I can. My wheel does nothing. Clearance issues. Okay, got it. See what it's got. I'm still turning my wheel, which is awesome.
Oh, yeah. I'm good at your pickup except for the tire rubber.
Yeah.
Are you turning the wheel?
I'm turning the wheel still.
And this is what we have accomplished after 2 weeks. Stay tuned for the gambling.
Next time on DawgStrip, we head back to the Penticton Speedway for another night of destruction. Our RV gets fired up and plows through anything in its path. Now, be sure to like and subscribe. We try to produce a video every month, and we have more crazy events lined up to come. Don't miss out on the next one.
Hammer. Works every time.
So proud of him.
Done.